Hello everyone, welcome back to the X Markets channel. Continuing the video series guiding the use of the MetaTrader 5 platform on Xness. In this video, I will guide you through screen display settings. Through this, I will guide you on how to use templates with this management method, allowing you to quickly set up different product tabs to create a beautiful and convenient chart for observing and monitoring the market. A beautiful chart is also a factor that helps us have a better trading mindset. This is the Xness Market Channel, where we provide the most useful information about trading activities on the Xness platform. We are a leading development partner of Xness. If you're new to Xness Market, make sure to hit the subscribe button to stay updated with our latest videos. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below, and our team will get back to you as soon as possible. You'll find the registration guide and the latest Xness updates in the video description and pinned comment. Besides this channel, you can also visit our Xness Market website to explore more about Xness. To set up the screen display or product chart, first, we will set it up to expand the product chart area. You can see the bottom part here. When we open the Toolbox tab, it will show us the account balance information like this. And here we can observe the trading history. When observing this section, we can completely adjust its display space. You can move the mouse pointer to the line below. A two-way arrow will appear. Then you click and drag. If you want to enlarge this space, you can drag it upwards. If you want to shrink it to observe the price chart better, you will drag it downwards. And if you want this information part to be close to the bottom, you can double-click on the bottom part. As you can see, I have quickly minimized the toolbox part. On the left side, we have the navigator or market watch bars. When we are done using these parts, we can completely hide them. You can click the X button to turn off these contents. Market Watch here is a list of products we are interested in. And when we have already displayed the chart, we will also turn it off. Here, you can see that the product list is quite short, right? However, in reality, this account can trade many different products. You can right-click on the Market Watch section and select Show All to display all the products that this account offers. We can drag any product out if we want to use it. And then we will turn it off when we are done. If you want to show it, you will go to the View section. Find Market Watch or Navigator. You can also find this functional tab here. Market Watch and Navigator. Next, we will set up the main chart area. You can see that the main chart area currently has a grid that is quite difficult to see. You can rig HT click on it and select Grid to remove the grid. Here, there are pre-existing indicators that MetaTrader 4 provides us. If you don't want to use them, right-click on the indicator and select Delete Indicator. If you want to use more indicators, you will go to the Navigator section, and I will have a separate video to introduce you to the part on using indicators. Here, you can see that by default, it is displayed as Japanese candlesticks. You can display the chart information in bar chart or line chart format if you want. However, usually, we just keep it in Japanese candlestick format. And even with candles, some of you prefer to use Heiken Ashi candles. You can find Heiken Ashi candles by going to the Navigator section. It will be in the Indicators section. Just find the Heiken Ashi candles among the indicators provided here. Here, you can see that the Heiken Ashi candles are in the Examples section and it is this candle. To set up Heiken Ashi candles on the screen, first, change the Japanese candles here to line chart format. Then, you drag the Heiken Ashi candles and drop them onto the screen. You can adjust the color for it. If you don't want to adjust the color, just click OK. Heiken Ashi candles are also a type of candle, but the way they calculate the open, close, high, and low points of the candle is different from Japanese candles. Therefore, you also need to learn a bit more. And the way to use this type of candle is also slightly different from the way to use Japanese candles. You can see there is a line here. This line chart line, it makes the Heiken Ashi candlestick chart difficult to see. So, we will hide that line by right-clicking on the screen. Select that. Then, for the line chart part, you click on it and set it to none. Then I will click OK. As you can see, very quickly, only the Heiken Ashi candles are displayed here. No longer the price line. Most commonly, you prefer to use the Japanese candlestick format. So now I will change this back to Japanese candlesticks. I will click on Japanese candlesticks. Then I will right-click on the screen. Select indicator list. I will click on the Heiken Ashi candle and delete it. Next, I will show the line chart part again. I will set it to a blue line format. The candle color here is currently green, with the inside of bearish candles being white. Now, I want a clearer distinction between bullish and bearish candles. So I will set bullish candles to green and bearish candles to orange. To adjust the candle color, I will right-click on the screen and select Properties. If you want to adjust the background, you will adjust it in Background. If you want to adjust the color of the data numbers here, you adjust the Foreground section. Here, I will give an example of changing to this color. Here is its preview. You can see that if I click OK, the number color here will change to this color. To adjust the bullish background color, we will adjust it in the Bar Up section. The border of the bullish candle I set to green. Bull candle is the inner fill of bullish candles. I will also change it to green. Bar down the outer fill here. I will change it to orange. Bear candle is the inner fill of bearish candles. I will also change it to orange. Some other settings below I will leave as default. And I will click OK. As you can see, the candle colors on the chart have been changed very quickly. If you want to display time separators to help you quickly see the correlation of today's price compared to yesterday's, or this week's compared to last week, etc., you will set it up as follows. Right-click on the screen. Select Properties. Next, there are small tabs here. Select the Show tab. Select Show Period Separators. Then click OK. You can see that time separator lines are now displayed here. When I display the time separator lines like this and set the time frame to H4, the distance between the two lines is 1 week. The beginning of the week will be this H4 candle, and the end of the week will be the last H4 candle. If I set it to D1, this time separator line will divide the months. The first candle is the first day of the month, and the last day of the month will be the last candle. When I switch to W1, these two time separator lines will display the time period in a year. The first week of the year is this candle, and the last week of the year is this candle. So, we can observe the price correlation of this year compared to last year more clearly. When you switch to MN timeframe, this time separator line also indicates the separation of years. When you select the H1 timeframe, this time separator line will separate the days. The beginning of the day will be this H1 candle, and the end of the day will be the last H1 candle. You can see two close lines like this. This is the display for Monday morning. The end of Friday will be this line. When we switch to Monday, after Monday runs for a few candles, it will display the time separator line for Monday starting from this candle. For Monday, it displays quite specially. The setup process I did here was only for the first tab. The subsequent tabs are still very unappealing and have no settings at all. And if I were to re-perform all the operations I set up for the first tab onto the second tab, it would be very time-consuming. There is a very scientific management method that you can use, which is to use templates. In the tab that I have set up here, I will select the Templates section. The Templates tab is not displayed on the toolbar by default. If you want it to appear, you will need to right-click on the toolbar and select Customize. This toolbar is the standard bar, so be careful it's the standard bar. Not other bars. Right-click on that bar, and you will find the Templates tab. Normally, the Templates tab is in the left column, and when it's in the left column like this, we won't see it on the screen. You need to move it to the right column. I will click here, then click Insert, and I will move it to the right column. And when I click Close like this, we will see the Templates tab on the standard toolbar. So, here I will select this Templates tab. I select Save Template, then I will name the template. For example, here I will name it X Trading 1. Then I click Save. Next, I will go to Other Product tabs. I will again find Templates and select X Trading 1. You can see that very quickly. All the characteristics we set up for this tab have been transferred to the next tab. Very fast, right? And for Other Product tabs, if you want to continue setting them up, you also select Templates and choose X Trading 1. This way, you can set up many different product tabs. And here, you can also save many different templates for your use. Each type of setting can have a different template. And so, I have finished introducing you to the operations for setting up the screen for the MetaTrader 5 platform on Exynos. I hope the information I provided is useful to you. If you have any questions during the setup process, you can leave a comment below the video, and the team will assist and answer you as soon as possible. Don't forget to give the video a like and click the subscribe button and the bell icon next to it to receive the latest videos when the channel